Good morning, it's Monday and at Ruru Sports Academy YouTube channel, we are ready to give you the updates in the world of football. And of course, starting you off is the English Premier League, where we had the mighty Liverpool losing to Watford FC. And of course, talking of Watford, they have won only 6 games. And of course, one is that of Liverpool with a very big margin of 3-0. Who could have expected this to happen? But remember, here at Ruru Sports Academy, we said that Watford, they are able to compete with these big teams. And of course, in the day, Klopp deciding to maintain his big names. Talk of Mo Salah, Sadio Mane, Van Dijk, Jabling. But what went wrong? He decided to maintain his formation of 4-3-3. But this time, he doesn't get it right. On the other hand, Watford deciding to use 4-2-3-1 formation and getting it right with a very big margin. Sar, Ismail Sar, you know, scoring twice, upsetting his fellow countryman Sadio Mane. Remember, they come from the same country. And of course, Troy Deeney scoring the third goal and giving Watford the well-deserved win. What happened or what went wrong from the Liverpool side? We would like to hear from you and we would like to know your views, and we would like to have a discussion and tell us why do you think Watford won against Liverpool. Majority are saying now it is time. Liverpool are starting to lose the grip of maintaining position one and winning the league. Remember, they have very good gap. They have won 26 games, draw one, and of course lost one. Will they carry or will they win the league? Talk to us. Let's continue having discussion. And of course, in other results, Norwich City playing against Leicester, and Norwich winning against Leicester with a 1-0 margin. Aston Villa versus Sheffield, the match was postponed, and we are waiting for the FA, of course, to give the dates and time of the game. Brighton playing against Crystal Palace, and of course, Crystal Palace upsetting Brighton at home and winning 1-0. And of course, Bournemouth playing against Chelsea. Chelsea, something is not right at Stamford Bridge, because they went for a draw, 2-2. And of course, Newcastle playing against Burnley, another draw, goalless draw. West Ham winning against Southampton with a big margin of 3-1. Watford, of course, we talked about it, and they won against Liverpool. And of course, Man City game against Arsenal also being postponed. Everton, talk it about Manchester United, drew 1-1. And of course, Tottenham against Wolves, and Wolves winning 3-2. What is happening to the Jose Mourinho side, Tottenham? This is yet another lose, having lost in the UEFA Champions League and now losing in the league. Let's continue discussing about football. Let's talking about these big results coming our way. And of course, next we are updating you about La Liga. Talking of La Liga, we had El Clasico. This is the most watched derby in the world, and of course, the most entertaining derby in the world. Real Madrid playing against Barcelona. Real Madrid being at home, Santiago Bernabeu upsetting Barcelona with 2-0, and Vinicius Junior, and of course, Mariano getting at the back of the net with very superb goals. And of course, Real Madrid playing very nice football, playing very compact game, very nice passes, getting a lot of chances in the game. Zinedine Zidane maintaining his 4-1-4-2 formation, and of course, maintaining all his big names, the likes of Marcelo, the likes of Sergio Ramos, the captain of the team, the likes of Benzema. Benzema playing very well, not scoring, but nice football from him. And of course, Isco and Vinicius showing that he can be one of the big names in the world, scoring a very superb goal. And on the other side, Setien, Barcelona coach, deciding to maintain his squad of the big names, Lionel Messi, Vidal, Sergio Busquets, but not playing very well. His squad not showing that they are the mighty Barcelona we know. And of course, his formation of 4-4-2 not working very well for him. Messi, questionable, you know, playing the game, and of course not playing very well as majority would have expected, and of course ending up losing in the game. Barcelona, why do you think they lost the game? In Madrid, why do you think they won the game? And in other matches, of course, we had Sevilla playing against Osasuna, and of course Sevilla winning 3-2, and of course Atletico Bilbao playing against Villarreal, winning 1-0. Espanyol against Atletico Madrid, and of course Atletico and Espanyol playing at a 1-1 draw. Getafe winning against Mallorca. Getafe is a team that has shown they are able to compete in the La Liga League, and of course now at fourth position. Continue watching us as we give you more in the Kenyan Premier League. Talking of Kenyan Premier League, where we had very entertaining matches on the weekend, and starting you off is Kisumu All-Stars. This is a team that is struggling to get its grips in the Kenyan Premier League, holding Tusker 2-2, and of course Sofapaka losing to Ulinzi Stars in the margin of 1-0. Chemelil Sugar losing to AFC Leopards with a margin of 1-0, and the mighty Kogalo, Gor Mahia. This is a team that has won the last two leagues, and of course winning against Western Stima with a margin of 3-2. Of course Wazito getting it right this time and winning against Zoo Kericho. We have Posta Rangers playing against Mathare United. This was a very, very tough match, and of course it ended to a 1-1 draw. Kakamega Homeboys, a team that is second in the Kenyan Premier League, a team that is chasing close to Gor Mahia, we winning it against Nzoia Sugar 3-2. And of course KCB playing against Bandari, and Bandari winning it 2-1. Talking of Kenyan Premier League, we have our own players who have made it in the Kenyan Premier League and went to other countries. Talk of Victor Wanyama in the European or English Premier League. He has not been playing at Tottenham. We never know whether he'll come back and, you know, continue playing. But let's talk of Francis Kahata, who has done wonders in the Tanzanian League, playing for Simba FC. This guy has scored 3 goals in this season, and he has made several assists. He has made big name in the Tanzanian League. Talk of Anthony Akumu in South African League, playing for Kaizer Chiefs. He has shown that he can play very well and also make Kenyans proud. Let's applaud and also remember these players are in our national team and continue doing well in those leagues, and this makes our country in the map of football. Not forgetting our own Real Sports Academy, where we train boys and girls age 5 to 17, boys and girls, and of course every Saturday we have our training session 8:30 to 11:30 at Ruru Stadium. Bring your child, bring your brother, bring your sister. Let's make champions, and also who can participate and compete in these world leagues. Karibu sana, and God bless you.